We are now start with the new topic, nuclear forces, which actually decide the nuclear stability. Before going to nuclear stability, we have to see what are the constituents of the nucleus. It is clear to you that a nucleus is made up of protons and neutrons. Protons are positively charged and neutrons are chargeless. And also, you know about the size of the nucleus. Nucleus is very compact and small sized one, where positively charged protons and neutrons are heavily concentrated. Due to this arrangement, definitely there will be proton-proton repulsion as they have the positive charge. This kind of repulsion sometimes destabilizes the nucleus. So, to explain the stability of nucleus, we have to consider the number of neutrons also. As the number of neutrons in a system increases, automatically repulsion between the protons comes down and stability of the nucleus slowly increases. If there is no neutron inside the nucleus, there will be only repulsion of protons can be seen and system will be highly unstable. So at present we have to understand that presence of neutron is actually the cause of decrease in the interproton repulsion. So the number of neutrons and protons together decide the ultimate stability of a nucleus. For this purpose, we are first explaining N by P ratio, where N is number of neutrons and P is the number of protons. So, neutron-proton ratio of a nucleus will ultimately decide whether that nucleus belongs to the category of stable nucleus or unstable nucleus. Nuclear stability can be explained using N by P ratio, and it is plotted in this graph. Number of protons along the x-axis and number of neutrons along the y-axis. Constitution of nucleus that we have already discussed, and interparticle interaction and stability, how they are related, is also explained. And if we come to N by P ratio, up to atomic number 29, that means copper, up to atomic number 20 or 29 maximum, N by P ratio is approximately equal to 1. What it indicates that for lighter elements from hydrogen to atomic number 29, number of neutrons and number of protons are approximately equal. That is why this ratio is found to be unity. Then we move again towards the higher end of the periodic table. With increasing atomic number or with increasing mass number, N by P ratio slowly increases from the unity or 1. This sentence I have written like this, then increases with increase in proton, means when proton increases, automatically neutrons also increases. If they increase, automatically mass number also increases, because mass number is the sum of protons and neutrons. So with increasing mass number or with increasing atomic number itself, N by P ratio slowly increases. So here, with this much of discussion, we come to the conclusion that for lighter elements, N by P ratio should be 1, and for heavier elements, it should be 1.6. If mass number crosses 200, we will reach 1/6. Again, once again, we are telling that for lighter elements, NBP ratio is 1 for stability, and for higher elements, NBP ratio 1 is not a good parameter for stability. There, it should be around 1.6. That means NBP ratio 1 means both are equal. NBP ratio 1.6 means number of neutrons should be around 60% higher than the number of protons. So, as the mass number increases, number of neutron increases, which reduces the interproton repulsion and keep up the nucleus stable. This can be clearly explained using this graph. This graph has three regions. One is red square, second one is green square, third one is black square. These are the three regions where you have to explain it clearly. Before going to the explanation, first of all you have to look into the graph and see that this dotted line is NBP equal to 1, which is plotted at an angle of 45 degree, where number of neutrons and protons are equal, so NBP is found to be 1. For lighter elements up to 20, atomic number 20 or maximum of 29, this graph is going to through the dotted line. That means they have NBP equal to 1. But with increase in atomic number, again it detaches from the dotted line and move up, and slowly it increases and reaches around 1.6 at higher end. So 1 is here and 1.6 is here. This shaded region, if any nucleus fall in this shaded region is called stability region. Stability region. If any nucleus comes to this region, then it will be a stable nuclei. If they come below the line or above the line or this region, they are unstable. So this is the only stability region of nuclei. By dividing number of neutrons by protons, you will get one value. If that value corresponds to this shaded area, then that nucleus is found to be stable, otherwise it is unstable. That is the thing which we have explained so far. Now this instability leads to radioactivity. Actually, radioactivity is due to the instability of the nucleus. So if a nucleus is found to be unstable, that nucleus definitely undergoes some kind of emission of radiations or particles like alpha, beta, positron, etc. to get stabilized, and this process continues until they fall into the stability belt. So each and every nucleus in unstable regions have a tendency to undergo radioactive disintegration. Finally they reach this stability region. First, we have to see this region where NBP ratio is less than 1. NBP ratio 1 is this line. Below this line, NBP ratio is found to be less than 1. For such nuclei, they are unstable and they have a tendency to improve their NBP ratio to 1, so that they will be stable. NBP ratio should be 1. For lighter elements, so they should increase. For such nuclei which are under this red region, they have two possibilities. One is positron emission, second is K electron capture. What is positron emission? Actually, positron emission is the reaction of this kind. What this equation indicate? Proton inside the nucleus you have to keep in mind that in our region n by p ratio is less than 1. What is the meaning? N by p ratio less than 1 in this region, what it means? That means number of neutron is less than number of proton. So to increase the n by p ratio and attain the stability, they have to increase number of neutrons and decrease or reduce the number of protons. So proton inside the nucleus get converted to neutron. Proton inside the nucleus get converted to neutron. Neutron is a chargeless particle, proton is a positively charged particle. So definitely there will be a question, what we have to do with the positive charge of proton? That positive charge of proton is removed as positron. Positron is nothing but a positively charged electron. Mass of positron is same as that of electron, but they have positive charge instead of the negative charge of electron. When proton, positron is emitted, proton get converted to neutron. Definitely, when proton get converted to neutron, n by p ratio increases. See example, nitrogen 713. When emit positron, what is positron? E plus 1. Plus 1 means it has a charge of proton, but mass is like electron. It is 7. Here it is plus 1. So remaining is 6. Here 13. Here we have 0. So 13, again 13 here. As it is 0, it is 13. So we have atomic number 6 here. That is carbon. So nitrogen get converted to carbon. Nitrogen 713. Nitrogen 713. What it means? It has 7 protons and 6 neutrons. Atomic number is number of proton. 13 minus 7 is the number of neutrons. So 6 neutrons and 7 protons. 6 by 7 is 0.86, less than 1. When it emit positron, it become carbon 613. Carbon 613 means 6 protons and 7 neutrons. 7 by 6 is greater than 1. 1.17. So it reaches higher stability region. This is the positron emission. This is how positron emission leads to the stability. Positron emission leads to the stability. Another possibility in this region is K electron capture. What is K electron capture? It is the abstraction of electron from the K shell. That is K electron capture. How it explain? Consider this atom, a nucleus surrounded by K shell and L shell. K shell contain 2 electrons and L shell also contain few electrons. When this nucleus is unstable and belongs to this region where n by p ratio is less than 1 due to less number of neutrons and more number of protons, system will try to reduce the number of protons by converting it into neutron. What actually happens is that proton inside the nucleus, abstract this electron from K shell. Abstract electron from K shell towards the nucleus, that proton combine with electron. Positive and negative combine to form neutral neutron. So proton get converted to neutron by abstraction of the K shell. That is K electron capture. Through the K electron capture, proton become neutron. So neutron increases and proton decreases again, n by p value increases. When K electron is captured from the K shell become incompletely filled. After the K electron capture, K shell contain only 1 electron, that is an unstable condition for electronic configuration. Definitely, electron from the second orbit come to this first orbit to fill the K shell. Since L shell is higher energy and K shell is of lower energy, definitely during this electronic transition from second to first level, some kind of energy is emitted, especially in the form of gamma radiation. Energy will be lost. So during this radioactive disintegration, gamma radiation will be emitted in the form of energy. These are the two possibilities in this region. That region is over. Example is beryllium 47. Abstract a proton from K shell and become lithium. Then N by P ratio increases from 0.7 to 1.33 and gamma radiation is emitted. That region is over. Then we have to see the green region. Where is green region? Here we have green region. In this green region, N by P ratio is greater than 1 because it is coming above this line of N by P equal to 1. Here N by P equal to 1. System is here. So here N by P greater than 1. So they have a tendency to reduce. That is N by P greater than 1 means. N by P greater than 1 means neutrons are higher and protons are less. Less protons and higher neutrons. So N by P ratio will reduce or decreases to 1 by conversion of neutron to proton. The neutron decreases and proton increases, then N by P ratio decreases. Here actually happen is beta electron, beta emission. What is beta? Beta is the emission of an electron from the nucleus. From the nucleus, we have neutron inside it. That neutron is actually a combination of proton and electron. This electron emits as beta particle and neutron get converted to proton. So inside the nucleus, neutron become a proton and a negatively charged beta particle is emitted. Example, carbon 614 having N by P ratio 1.33, which seems to be unstable, and when beta particle is emitted, 6 7 minus 1 6, 14 14 0, they are balanced. So nitrogen is formed. Then N by P equal to 1. 7 by 7, N by P is 7 by 7, that is 1. Again moves to stability belt. Then the third region. Where is third region? This is the third region, upper right corner of the graph. That is the region where stability is found to be at N by P equal to 1.6, not at 1. N by P is equal to 1.6, then only that higher elements will become stable, that we have discussed in the initial part of this video. Under that region, alpha emission is possible. N by P should be approximately equal to 1.6. See uranium 90 to 238, which has N by P equal to 1.58. You have to divide the number of neutron by number of proton. It is 146 by proton is 92, then you will get 1.58. when it emit alpha particle, that is helium nucleus, alpha particle is emitted and uranium become thorium 90 to 34, then it is 144 by 90, that is N by P, that is 1.6. it moves to the more stability region. N by P should be 1.6 for heavier elements like uranium and thorium, so they will again move to the stability region. These are the three possibilities in this N by P ratio graph. So this is an important part in explaining the stability of the nucleus. The N by P ratio, for explaining this, we have to consider the graph. Graph clearly shows a stability belt or stability region where nucleus is found to be stable. Those elements which lies below and above that stability region are found to be unstable. So they are radioactive. They will undergo some radioactive disintegration processes so that they can attain the stability. For that, they have many, many possibilities. If it is come below the stability belt, that is in the red region, n by p is found to be less than 1, and there they have to increase the n by p ratio to 1 or above 1 by k electron capture or positron emission. In the green region, n by p ratio is greater than 1, so they have to reduce it to 1, which is possible through beta particle emission. And at higher end of black region, where elements are found to be heavier elements, their stability is not at 1, it is at 1.6, so they emit alpha particle and slowly increases stability towards the 1.6. Okay, with this we come to the end of n by p ratio, which is actually related to the stability of the nucleus. Okay, thank you.